Hi, this is Gary Lee Stanley, your sales guy. Hey, we're going to talk about my favorite subject today, which is sales. All right, we got a great subject for today, and the subject for today is kind of neat. It's a nice sales technique that is very old, and people have been using it for a long time, and I'm excited to bring it back to you so you can try it out. You can even use it in your own life. Oh my gosh, I've made so many decisions in my life based on this just one close. So here's what it is. It's called the Ben Franklin close. What is that? Ben Franklin. You remember that guy. You know, he had the kite and the electricity. Oh, crap. And then he had those nice glasses that he invented. Well, he also helped sign the Declaration of Independence. That's a pretty good guy. Well, he had an idea he came up with. He was a steadfast, hard worker. He was a very rich man. And, you know, he was a pretty smart guy. So I guess, you know, somebody saw something that he had done, which he would use to make decisions based on positives and negatives, good or bad. That makes sense. But see, what the simplicity comes into play here is that he would write it down. He'd have a piece of paper at the top. He'd have the thing that he was wanting to accomplish or something he was thinking about doing. On the left side, it would be the positives, the things that are good. On the right side, they're the negatives, or vice versa, whichever which way you want to write your list. Then what he would do is he would ask himself questions. Well, what would this benefit me? If I do this, on the left side, I'll be able to save money. I'll be able to, you know, be able to look down and have a better future. And on the right-hand side, write down the negatives. So whichever one had the most, that's what generally he would do. And that's what generally I would do. I mean, anybody who has any common sense, if you got features and benefits, and the benefits don't outweigh what it's going to cost, then it makes sense to go ahead and move on to the next thing. That's just really, really important. But the Ben Franklin close came into my life when I was selling electronics. I used to sell big screens, computers, and it was just state-of-the-art video camcorders back in the day. And what they used to do is they would say, Gary, when you talk to your customer, okay, if they balk and they don't want to maybe purchase something, what you need to do is just ask some simple questions. And what you'll do is they've come into the mall and they come into your store. They did come to somebody to intrigue them, maybe give them that impulse and that purchase want to buy. But what you would do is you'd get out your piece of paper and you say, hey, you know who Ben Franklin is, don't you? And most people say, yeah, the kite guy, the electricity. And then you'll say, well, you know, he used to make those very big decisions when he was trying to spend a lot of money, and or if he was trying to do anything that was of value. He would make a list of the positives and the negatives. And I have a piece of paper here, so let's take a look at what the positives and the negatives are. So if it makes sense to you, okay? And generally they'll say, okay. And then what you'll do is you'll ask some pertinent questions that are positive. It's going to look real good in the home. It's going to be used by everyone. Down the road, it's going to save you money. And then on the left, you might put maybe one thing. It costs you money. And then what you'll do is you'll have the customer say, help me, you know, we'll figure out all the positives for this. And then you'll look at the list. And in this particular type opportunity, if the list has more positives, you got a sale. Oh my gosh. And listen, it's just another tool in your toolbox. There are so many opportunities, and you really got to have these extra tools. Remember, the Ben Franklin close can also help you in making good decisions, sound decisions, and things that can help you develop your career in selling or in any job or business that you're running. The Ben Franklin close, again, it's just real simple. You just take the benefits and the things that aren't the benefits, and remember, which of the two columns matches up with the most, and you look them in the eye. Well, ma'am, sir, based on the information that we have here, it looks like you've already made a decision. And they'll say, yeah. I said, it's a really good choice. So did you want to go ahead and go with that now? Shut up. And listen. And a lot of times they'll say, okay. And then sign it up, because you've given them so many benefits. You've showed them so many features. You did the Ben Franklin. Oh my gosh. You know, I just love using different types of sales techniques and closing techniques. We're not manipulators, okay? Listen, you don't manipulate people. You don't take advantage of your clients. That's just not the way we do business. But if we, again, can show that there are more benefits that line up for the customer And if they can see themselves, because you're going to visually put them in the picture of owning your product, you're going to use the KISS method, you're going to keep it really, really simple, and also you're going to ask for the order. And this is a very good way to say, hey, look, I'm not making the choice here. It looks like you've already made your decision, right? And just smile. And as you're signing it and you're looking at them, you say, well, we'll get this delivered out to you. When would you like it, Thursday or Friday? And you've given another close. By the way, you've already had conversation about the financing, and all you have to do is literally write it up.